Multiplexer, decoders and encoders today. Next, let us see what a multiplexer is. This is one which has n control inputs and one output, that is it is many to one, and the number of inputs is designed by 2 to the power n. So it is actually is routing the selected data input to the output. So the value of the control inputs determines the data that has to be selected. As you can see here, you have a multiplexer. S0, S1 are select lines, and since there are two select lines, you can have four data inputs. So that means out of these four, one of them is selected and is sent to the output. So let us see the logic circuit for this. So for example, if you take one select line, okay, and you can have one means 2 to the power 1, which is 2. Two inputs are available. They are gated through these 1 and 2. So finally, these outputs are connected through an OR gate. That means if any of the inputs are high, the output is going to be high. That means either 1 is high or 2 is high, the output of this OR gate is going to be high. So if you take, this is an inverter. So before inverter, it is connected to 1. After inverter, it is connected to 2. So if you take 0, then 1 is going here, 0 is going here. So if you take 0, S bar, S as 0, this gate is going to be 0. That means this gate is going to be 0. So if it is 0, this is I0 will be selected. If it is 1, then 1 means this is going high, so this gate is going to be selected. So if S is 0, it selects I0 input. And if S is equal to 1, it selects I1 gate. Next. Similarly, you can also have 4 inputs. 4 inputs, how do you get 4 inputs? You select 2 select lines, S0 and S1. If there are 2 inputs, you can have 4 different input combinations. 0, 0, it will select I0, because if this is 0 and this is 0, that means you are going to give this as 0. Where is 0 going here? So this is 0, this is 0. So it's going to the output here as this is 1, this is 1. Both are 1. If I0 is also going to be 1, then this gate is selected. Depending on which gate, 1, 2, 3, 4, which of these AND gates are selected, that particular input will be selected, and that drives the final OR gate here. So if you take S1 and S0 to be 0, then these two inputs are high and it will select I0. If this is 0, output is going to be 0. If this is 1, output is going to be 1. Similarly, if you take 0 and 1, 0 and 1, this input I1 will be selected because all the other gates are low. And final gate being R, if any of these inputs are high, the output is going to be high. So if I1 is selected here, if I1 is the input that is given is 0, the output is going to be 0. If the input I1 is 1, output is going to be 1. So depending on what inputs you are giving here, the same output will be coming here. Next, demultiplexes. We talked about multiplexes as many to one. Demultiplexer is one to many. It is just the reverse of multiplexes. So it has n control inputs but only one data input. And the number of data outputs is determined once again by 2 to the power n. So it routes or connects the data input to the selected output. The value of the control inputs determines the output that is being selected. So it performs the opposite function of a multiplexer. So let us take the example of 1 to 4 line demultiplexer. So data input here in this case is only 1. This input is available on any one of these outputs. Which output it is available is determined by the select lines S1 and S0. So if you take 0 and 0, then this is going to be on which line? It is going to be on this line. So D0, it is available, if this is S0 and 0, it is available on D0 line. 0 and 1, it is available on D1 line. 1, 0 on D2 line. 1, 1 on D3 line. So example, 0, 0, it has to be 0. So it is available on this line. If you give 0, you get 0 at the output. If A is given as 1, you get the output as 1. Again, 0, 1, selection is, the output is available. It is active, low output. So it is available here. If you give 0, you get 0. If you give 1, you get 1. Similarly, you take 1, 0, then it is available on O2. Output is available on this O2 line. 0 means 0, 1 means 1. Like this it will go. Typical applications of this multiplexer are, you have, let us say, different devices connected, like MP3 player, a laptop, a satellite, a digital cable TV. Now, out of this, any one of these is connected to a speaker or a sound system. That means sound system can be connected either to a mobile phone, MP3 player, a laptop, a satellite or a cable TV. From where it is coming is decided by this here. So if you take 00, it is MP3, 01 is laptop, 10 is satellite and 11 is digital cable. So you have to write a code accordingly and then the selection is made. Similarly, the applications of demultiplexer. As we have seen, multiplexer is many to one. Now it is one to many. One source is single selection and it is going to multiple destinations. That is, from the system, from the computer system, it can go to printer, it can go to fax machine, color printer or some other device like pen plotter. So if you take 00, it goes here, 01 fax machine, 10 is this, 11 is this. So one to many, what information you are giving to A, B, accordingly the device is selected. So they can also be used in communication systems, transmitting different type of data such as audio, video at the same time using a single transmission line. Also in telephone network where different multiple audio signals are integrated, computer memory, you have slotted memory and it can be directed, transmission from the computer system to a satellite. Any of these applications, multiplexers are used. Now, wherever multiplexers are used, demultiplexers are also used, because to transmit you need a multiplexing device, to receive you need demultiplexing. It's generally used in combination. They work together for transmission and reception of communication systems. In arithmetic and logical unit, the output of ALU can be stored in multiple registers or storage units with the help of demultiplexer. So it is fed as data input to the multiplexer and this is also used for the selection. Now let us see what a decoder is. It is a logic circuit which accepts a set of inputs that represents a binary number and activates only the output that corresponds to that input number. So it's basically it is a circuit which determines which binary number is present and activates that output corresponding to that. It's decoding actually. So it has 2 power n input codes, n inputs and m outputs. 2 power n input codes are available, but only one output is high for each of the input. So this is an example, 2 to 4 decoder it is. So if you have 2 inputs A0 and A1, it can be available on any one of these. So if it is available on D0, the combination is A0 bar A1 bar, that means 00. 01 10 11. So if it is 00, the decimal number is 0 and it is available on D0. 01, decimal number being 1, it is available on D1 output. 10, the decimal number is 2, it is available on D2. 11, number is 3 and it is available here. So it is basically converting a binary number, the decimal number, into the binary sequence. This is the decimal number at the input and you are getting the output as decimal number. There are some decoders which are available with enable signal also. That means in addition to inputs A and B, we also have an enable signal, which is a high level enable. That means only if it is high, it is enabled. If it is zero, it is disabled. Once it is disabled, A and B are called as don't cares. That means whatever be the value of A and B, your output is not going to be affected. It continues to be in the same state as it was before. So therefore, there is no change here. But when enable is 1, then only it is enabled. So if you take 0, 0, then it is available at the output 0. 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 2, and 1, 1, 3. So this is a decoder with enable. The same circuit is alternately written here. What is then encoder? An encoder is exactly opposite of a decoder. Encoder accepts an active level on one of the inputs representing the digit, such as a decimal or octal digit, and it converts it into a coded output such as BCD or binary. They can also be devised to encode various symbols and characters. Basically, this encoding is to code, decode is to read what is written as code. So example is, it is a reverse of decoder. So M inputs and N outputs. Only one is high at a time, and this is the output. So let us see in a nutshell what an encoder is, what a decoder is. Encoder has one input activated at a time and it gives binary coded output. Here a decoder, only one output activated at a time, it is binary code input. So what are you doing here? You are converting binary to octal, octal to binary. So this is also referred to as octal to binary encoder. As you can see here, outputs are these three. Octal inputs are given, you are getting binary. Because three inputs, if you give, you get 2 to the power 3, 8. 8 is octal. So if you just see this, if E0 is high, that is if one of the inputs is high, it is available, the decimal corresponding code is 0. So this is 1, that means 001, it is 1. This is 2, this is 3. 4, 5 means 5th input, the corresponding decimal code is 5. E6 means 6th input, the code correspondingly is 6, and so on. So only one and at least one input line being active at a time. Examples are, let us say, you have a single camera with stereo audio point to point encoder to decoder over a LAN, web or WAN. So you have an audio signal and HDMI signal connected to monitor. Then it can be audio or this. Any one of these is active at a time, and then it is given to multi-monitor. This is another example. You have different systems through cable services. All these are monitored, multiplexed, encoded, decoded. Depending on which device the transmission is given, accordingly it is chosen.